A modern and innovative fighter jet, featuring the most advanced technology available in the 21st century, was designed, built, and flown in the span of a year by the U.S. Air Force. This sixth-generation fighter jet is expected to become the centerpiece of the Next Generation Air Dominance program. The technological growth of the last decades has undeniably transformed the aviation industry in the entire world, and as the Air Force's biennial 2019-2020 report for acquisition states, quote, "A highly advanced dynamic threat demands a different way of doing things." A big announcement. In the fall of 2020, the U.S. Air Force revealed its sixth-generation fighter jet as part of its next-generation air dominance program. The aviation world was surprised by the announcement, but even more to learn that the aircraft had already been designed, built, and tested within a single year. The Air Force's biennial report indicated that, quote, "By executing shorter technology development cycles, the program matures technology and reduces risk through prototyping and operational experimentation. This delivers enhancements in survivability, lethality, and persistence for a highly contested environment." Next Generation Air Dominance, or NGAD, is an advanced aircraft program that allows air superiority in challenging environments, supported by digital engineering, nimble software development, and open architectures. This digital engineering employs virtual modeling and simulation tools to dramatically shorten the time of development, and it is for, quote, "development of penetrating counter-air platforms with multi-domain awareness, agile, resilient communications, and an integrated family of capabilities." Meanwhile, non-traditional acquisition approaches are used, quote, "to avoid traditional monolithic program schedules and exorbitant lifecycle sustainment costs." This strategy, called the Digital Century Series approach, creates a realistic business case for industry to adopt commercial best practices for key design activities before a part is even manufactured. For instance, the F-35 Joint Strike Fighter program had a reputation as being one of such monolithic programs, suffering from repeated setbacks and budget-busting issues, a perfect example of inadequate acquisition practices. It was disclosed in September of 2020 that a prototype had already been built and flown, but the report only provided vague and sparse details. The fighter is supposed to be among the first sixth-generation American fighters, if not the first, but given the mystery surrounding the announcements, most journalists assumed that the prototype was not yet a completed aircraft design. Instead, the fighter appeared to be a technology demonstrator, testing different systems for the next generation. Moreover, it is likely that the Air Force doesn't yet have a definitive aesthetic for the fighter, although the artist's renderings do provide intriguing visual cues. A graphic depicting an unknown triangular fighter jet was also released for the U.S. Air Force's 73rd anniversary, which coincided with the NGAD announcement, and the design didn't resemble any of the current operational fighters. Although firms like Lockheed Martin had already published concept art for sixth-generation fighters, it is possible that both the timing of the announcement and the artwork were intentional, and that these previous designs may have influenced the piece. New Generation. Poised to replace the advanced but increasingly rare F-22 Raptor and the highly capable fourth-generation F-15, this new jet will be a multi-role fighter. But beyond admitting its existence and the fact that it features F-1-style engineering, not much more information was released, except for the intriguing concept art. The image depicts a diamond-shaped fighter jet with extensive engine air intakes over its wings, trailing to the sides of the cockpit, which would shield them from radar from below. In addition, the image also features two engines and a bubble canopy. The vertical retractable stabilizers, which fold flat into the wings, increase stealth while in the down position. Keeping such a feature must have specific benefits, like enhanced maneuverability and fuel efficiency. The artwork also suggests the adoption of a wedge-shaped, tailless aircraft. Older models, like the F-22 and F-35, feature fairly traditional tail sections, though they maintain stealthy contours. Nevertheless, the precedent for a tailless aircraft is tangible. As for the armament, it can be inferred that the aircraft will be able to carry three air-to-air missiles internally, a must for neutralizing radar return and keeping stealth. Also, the diagram shows three jet engines and the caption "Digital Experimentation," which coincides with the latest Air Force tendency to leverage more digital testing than ever before. It is also hinted that the aircraft may be refitted with weapon and propulsion upgrades, absorbing rather complicated upgrades rapidly, probably due to the advantage of simulation technologies. Whereas modern combat aircraft usually receive new weapons, refitting an existing aircraft with upgraded engines is complex. Below the main aircraft image, a second graphic appears to show the technology's progression, but it may also suggest that not only one isolated model would be produced, but rather an entire family of innovative systems. Judging by its appearance, the aircraft looks like it was built for speed and stealth, and inside its blended body and wing configuration, an ample weapons bay could store fuel as well as weapons. The Air Force reportedly requires a fighter with a specific range to escort bombers into deep penetration missions, demanding a considerable internal fuel supply. Planning ahead. U.S. Air Force Chief of Staff General Charles Q. Brown Jr. testified on the fiscal 2022 budget request for the program and explained that although the aircraft's primary role will be air dominance, it will also have, quote, some air-to-ground capability to ensure, one, that it can survive, but also to provide options for our air component commanders and for the joint force. An increased range and weapons load compared to the F-22 is also foreseen, which would allow it to operate in the Indo-Pacific region and reach significant distances. General Mark D. Kelly, head of Air Combat Command, explained that there may be two variants of NGAD. The first would have an extended range and payload needed for the Indo-Pacific, while the second would be oriented to shorter range missions and possible battle areas in Europe. The fighter, however powerful, would not be operating alone. Described as a family of systems, the NGAD would feature the fighter jet as its center, but the graphics hint that the aircraft would connect to satellite and airborne communication nodes, allowing the pilot to join nearby friendly forces via a stream of data. Air Force airborne warning aircraft or Navy destroyers could also help paint a picture of a battlefield, while the fighter wouldn't need to turn on its own radar or sensors. This collaboration is what the Air Force describes as multi-domain awareness. General Brown also explained that the U.S. Air Force plans include reducing its fighter fleet, keeping only four types: the F-35, F-15EX, F-16, and the NGAD. The new fighter would fly alongside the F-35, with the latter as, quote, the cornerstone, F-15EX as we come in, and then we'll have F-16 for a while as well. The Department of Defense's published budget request stipulates that the funding for the new NGAD is $1.5 billion, approximately $623 million more than previous economic aid. This budget request is dated 2022. Ultimately, the U.S. Air Force's prototype already seems to be a glimpse into the future, or as Will Roper, a top acquisition official, put it, quote, "We've already built and flown a full-scale flight demonstrator in the real world, and we broke records in doing it. We are ready to go and build the next-generation aircraft in a way that has never happened before." Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe to our Dark Documentaries channels to hear more about military advancements from the past and the present. And don't forget to give us a thumbs up and tell us in the comments below what you think of the new fighter jet.